A good multi-tool is probably the most important piece of equipment that you can have in your back pocket. But there are just so many. I mean, there is a baffling amount of options of multi-tools. So in this video, I'm going to go through the different options and show you what's important and what's nice to have. There are hundreds of different types of multi-tools. Big ones, small ones, heavy ones, light ones, cool ones, practical ones. Yeah, you get the idea. So how on earth do our cyclists pick out the ones we need? And by that, I mean for the bike and the riding we're gonna be doing. From a weekend simple 30 miler to an epic gravel race, you're gonna need a different kind of multi-tool for the job in hand. So to start off with, I thought I'd give you some key aspects of what to look for in your multi-tool that suit, well, the majority of riding you're gonna be doing. Unless you're riding a belt drive bicycle, you're gonna want one of these, a chain breaker. No matter how new or old your chain is, it could break. If it's worn or old, the higher the risk is of it breaking. So having one of these is gonna stop you from getting stranded or scooting your bike all the way home. And from personal experience, that takes hours. Nearly every multi-tool has a set of Allen keys. The one thing to check though is that your multi-tool fits the bolts on your bike, especially bolts on your seat post, your stem, and your bars, because these are bolts that you might want to adjust while out on the road. Some bikes may use torque bolts, like my F12 here. It uses torque bolts for the saddle post clamp. So the last thing you want to do is buy a multi-tool that you can't adjust your saddle height. Now you can kind of think about what kind of size multi-tool you go for. Are you doing short rides, fast rides, group rides, racing? Well, I tend to go for something a lot smaller with all the essentials, but it's nice and lightweight like this one. But you could be going for those long endurance rides or those epic gravel adventures. Then I would suggest you go for something like this. Yes, it's bigger, it's bulkier, but yet it's got a whole load of functions to go with it. So when you're far away from home and your chain breaks, you've got something to be able to fix it. So you're not left stranded and having to have that embarrassing phone call to a family member or paying a huge taxi fare. That will sort you out. Something else to consider is the style of your multi-tool. Now that could be looks, but also practical uses too. The standard multi-tool looks a bit like this one here with a whole load of multitude of functions, but all nice and tightly tidied away like that one. Or you could go for something a little bit different like this ratchet one I've got here. It's still got all the tools used, but it's a slightly different setup. It's slimmer, it's light, and it packs nicely in a jersey pocket. So you've picked out your multi-tool. You've got one for the riding you're gonna be doing and the bike you've got. The next big question is, where on earth are you gonna put it? Where are you gonna carry it? A lot of people tend to use saddlebags. Now, saddlebags are great because you set the saddlebag up and you don't have to remember where your multi-tool is every time you get on your bike. All you have to do is put your saddlebag on. But if you're a rider like me who likes to be lightweight and you don't like to be bulky with a saddlebag, then the next best thing is to put it in your jersey pocket. There are a whole range of different multi-tools out there and you might just need a couple, one for a tubeless setup, one for a different type of bike or different rides. The key thing to remember though is that you're self-sufficient. You're ready for every eventuality. So I hope you enjoyed this video. It's given you some tips for when looking for a multi-tool and hopefully you won't have to use them, but when you do, you'll be able to sort every problem out. Let me know in the comment section below what you thought of this video, and good luck and have fun in your next rides.